I'm thinking about the whole new pirate look.
Yeah.
Double eye patch.
What would you call that pirate? Blindy?
Welcome to another episode of 3 Minute Critics. I am Eric.
I am not Eric. And today on 3 Minute Critics, we will be reviewing the film The Gentleman.
We are.
Rated R.
And it is rated R.
Starring a bunch of folks.
A lot.
Including Matthew McConaughey.
Yes.
Charlie Hunnam.
He's in it.
Hugh Grant.
He's also in
Michelle
it.
Michelle Dockery.
She's in it.
Colin Farrell.
Definitely.
Directed by Mr. Guy Ritchie.
And this is a great story. An American expat tries to sell off his highly profitable marijuana empire in London, triggering plots and schemes, bribery and blackmail.
And alliteration.
Yeah, in an attempt to steal his domain out from under him. All sorts of crazy stuff going on in this
Tons
film.
Tons of craziness.
It is a Guy Ritchie, a Gritchie film. So
Ritchie? It's a
Gritchie
film.
It's a Gritchie film.
It's a
Gritchie
film.
As always, we are going to put 3 minutes on the clock. We are going to get right to the action. And
yes, we are.
Tony, what did you think of The Gentleman?
I thought it was a little bit scattered.
It's a little bit country and a little bit rock and roll?
Yes.
Okay.
Thank you.
Tell me
Donnie
why
Marie.
You think it was a little scattered.
I felt like the pace and the storyline were not very tight. I thought it was it's a good overarching story, but the actual dialogue and the pace and the editing of the film was a little slow. And what did you?
It took too long to tell the story.
No. Just like I think that certain things needed to be edited in different ways so that the story could be told with a little more of a clip. The surprises and the twists were great.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't dislike the film, but I felt like because of that, that wasn't really my main problem.
Okay.
A second.
Okay, then maybe one of my issues with this might be yours too.
Okay.
So. To me, normally a Guy Ritchie film, I gotta say, I went in with certain expectations because he delivers some films that I really love. Movies like Snatch and Lock, Stock, and Smoking Barrels. There's just this sort of like look about it. There's this action about it. There's like his great slow-mo shots. There's
didn't have any of that.
A lot of really cool flashback moments. And in this,
I didn't feel like it was shot very well.
From the beginning, here's a few things that I just didn't love about it.
Go.
Matthew McConaughey.
Yeah.
Just being an American, I get it that it's about him in London trying to sell off his. I didn't believe him that much. It felt like he walked right out of one of his Lincoln commercials.
Well, that's the thing.
Into this, and it wasn't really a Guy Ritchie character. I didn't feel like Matthew McConaughey's character in this was a true Guy Ritchie character. Whereas,
I don't even think that's the issue. Was that it was a Guy Ritchie character or not a Guy Ritchie character? I think the problem was McConaughey's performance was very weak.
It was flat.
It was very flat, especially when you surround him with performances by Hugh Grant, who was amazing.
He was great.
Yeah, I thought Hugh Grant was phenomenal. And also Colin Farrell.
Okay. I love...
Unbelievable.
Colin Farrell as Coach. By the way,
he
first
was fantastic.
Of all, this character of Coach, I would have loved to have seen a lot more of him. That was more like... like Bricktop or somebody
Absolutely.
In one of Guy Ritchie's other films, where it's a side character, but you really, really,
I
really get
him.
Involved with that.
He was great.
I thought a little bit of the telling of the story from the viewpoint of... Hugh Grant and Charlie Hunnam, Fletcher and Ray going back and forth.
Yeah.
I would have liked kind of just more of a traditional telling
I
of
didn't
this
mind
stuff.
That. That part of it I didn't mind. I think the problem was
I got a little lost
more
going back and forth to all that.
The problem was McConaughey. Every time you get back to McConaughey, you're like...
And he's...
He was such a snooze.
In
and he
this
wasn't
film.
Believable in this film.
And
I agree. I like
and
him
I think
in
his,
things.
You're right. And this character just didn't really fit a Guy Ritchie film. I think if you had somebody...
Again, it's the acting.
Yeah.
Had you had an actor, a performance that was more suitable to that character, would have worked.
Potentially.
And I really think McConaughey is pretty much the wreck of this film.
Well...
Speaking of wrecks...
Well, yeah, it sounds like our car just wrecked, our car horn. And that means we are out of time. It is now time to rate this movie.
And we will be rating this film on a 5-star scale. And Eric will be starting the ratings.
I will. It's tough to rate this movie all on its own. It was a little flat overall to me.
Mm-hmm.
This wasn't the punch that I usually love from a great Guy Ritchie film.
Not a lot of punch.
Some really good performances in here, but some that were just okay. So I was entertained, but I would have loved more from this. And for that reason, I give it 2.5. Out of 5 stars. 2.5 out of 5 stars. Tony, what'd you think?
Okay, so I think this film, I feel similarly about this. I feel like McConaughey pretty much ruined the film. But I don't think he had a brilliant film without him. I think if you had the right performer in that role, I still don't think it's brilliant, but it would have been better. But again, shout out to Hugh Grant, who was phenomenal. I really loved
him. And Colin Farrell.
And Colin Farrell. But as a whole, I also agreed 2.5. 2.5.
It's kind of a middle of the road film. As always, you're going to need to go check it out for yourself. See what you think.
Or not.
Yeah, it's up to you.
That's why we're here.
Yeah, we tell you what we like. Maybe you like it, maybe not.
We're helping you out. We're here to serve. We serve you.
We try.
We are here to serve.
And we'd like to serve you up some more fantastic movie reviews. So we'd love for you to subscribe right up here, right up in this general area. And then you'll see more of our fantastic movie reviews. But until next time, we are the
3 Minute Critics, baby.